Let's start at the beginning with a real simple lesson about our bodies. Hi, I'm Nadine Thornhill, sexuality educator. Welcome to Save Sex Ed, the series where I teach every sex education module from Ontario's Health and Phys Ed curriculum. If you're new to the channel, you can click down below to subscribe. And if you'd like to learn more about this series, you can click the I that is somewhere above my head. The Health and Phys Ed curriculum for grades 1 through 8 outline the following objectives for grade 1. Identify body parts, including genitalia, using correct terminology. This is the first sexual health learning objective in the entire curriculum. It's the only one for first grade, and it is really simple. So we are going to keep our activity simple as well. For your materials, you are going to need 2 diagrams or illustrations. One of a child with penis and testicles, and one of a child with a vulva. All we're going to do for this exercise is a head-to-toe naming of all the body parts. If you want to mix it up, you could also go toe to head. But we're going to keep it really simple. We're just talking about the body parts that our students can see or feel. Starting off, we have hair, head, eyes, nose, mouth, ears, neck, shoulders, chest, arms, hands, fingers, stomach, back, hips, buttocks, vulva or penis, testicles, legs, feet, toes. And that's it. You can keep the activity as basic as that. If you want to add a little bit more, you can ask your students about the different ways that our body parts can be. There are parts of our bodies that can be different colors, you know, our hair, our eyes, our skin. Parts of our bodies can be different shapes. Under here, I have hair that is very, very curly. Other people have hair that is very, very straight. Some people have hair that is wavy or it's curly, but maybe less curly than mine. Some people have round stomachs. Some people have curvy stomachs. Some people have flat stomachs. Some people have very long legs. Some people have shorter legs. Body parts come in different numbers. I have 2 arms. Some people have 1 arm. Some people have no arms. Some bodies need assistance. Some people wear glasses to help them see. Some people might use a cane to help them walk or braces to help their legs stay upright. Some people might use a wheelchair or a scooter to get around. They might use something like a computer or a bliss board to help them communicate and talk with people. Body parts can come from different places. Some of us have arms or legs that we were born with. Other people may have an arm or a leg that was made for them and attaches to the rest of their body. If you need a more modest adaptation of this activity for your classroom, you can also use an illustration of a child who is wearing underpants or a bathing suit bottom. You can still name all the body parts, including the genitals. You just don't have to show them. Allow for giggles or other reactions from your students. You can reassure them that that is a very normal reaction because a lot of us just aren't used to seeing people who are undressed very often. But you can also remind them that we all have a body and we all have body parts, and it's important to learn what they are called. I recommend not gendering the body parts. Not everyone with a penis is a boy. Not everyone with a vulva is a girl. So this just avoids a lot of confusion down the line. Children, like the rest of us, don't really need to see people's genitals in order to pick up clues about their gender identity. If you want to teach your kids about body parts at home, you can start these lessons pretty much as soon as they are born. Parents and caregivers often talk to their kids and name body parts as they're, you know, dressing them or giving them a bath. So feel free to do that and just simply include the words penis, testicles, and vulva in your lexicon. Remember that children know they have genitals. They can feel them. They can see them. All we are doing is telling them that, like the rest of their bodies, those parts of their bodies also have names. Here are a couple of conversation prompts you can use if you want to have further discussion with your young kids about bodies. What are some things you really like about your body? How can we take care and be kind to our bodies? A couple of books that I really love that deal with body parts are It's Not the Stork by Robie Harris and What Makes a Baby by Cory Silverberg. In the comments below, let me know what you were taught to call your genitals as a child. I was actually taught to call my vulva a vulva. So way to go, mom and dad. That's all for now. I hope you have a great day and I will see you soon. Bye.
You can help me continue creating free sex ed content by supporting me on Patreon. For as little as $3 a month, you'll get access to all sorts of goodies, so head on over to patreon.com/NadineThornhill or click the link down in the description below.